Bonjour tout le monde, c'est moi, Monsieur Springer. C'est l'hiver, il neige. I can't believe winter came so early on us this year. I hope you enjoy the holiday season in December and the cool weather as much as I do, although I know not everybody loves the snow in Michigan, but it's a wonderful time of year. I want to talk about a few things as we get ready to wrap up our course, because believe it or not, we're at the end of the semester already. As soon as we enter December, we're basically at the end of the semester because we've got a few weeks here, got winter break, and then January just flies by. Some of you have a end date of January 6th this year. Others are entering a week or two after that. Make sure you know your end date, okay? And if you're not sure what your end date is, ask me or your mentor and I'll let you know, okay? I want to talk about some strategies here as we near the end of the semester. And this video is designed for parents and mentors as much as students because the end is really important to understand a few key things to be successful. First thing I want to mention is that the first 3 weeks of December are the best time for students to really push and catch up if they're behind. It's the time that I'm most available to help you. It's the time where I'm going to be able to provide the best feedback on your work. As we get further on in December and then January, I don't really leave feedback anymore because so much student work comes at the very end of the semester. I simply don't have time to give the detailed coaching and feedback that I did earlier in the semester. And even in December, it's later than it's going to be for October and November. So try to really push hard this first 3 weeks of December. If you need help with something or want to work with me, let me know early because I will do whatever I can to rearrange things to work with you, whereas in January it's a little bit harder. Another thing that's important in French 1A in particular is the following. There are a couple of assignment types that are absolutely crucial. Not only are they worth quite a bit of points, but they're actually required. And if you look at the welcome letter I sent you at the beginning of the semester, I mentioned one of the expectations in class is completing all assignment types. That means like not just multiple choice quizzes, but writing assignments, speaking, video, the phone call assignment with me, all of it's required. And the reason for that is that in order for your school to give you credit, we want to make sure that we are doing what the state standards dictate in terms of what world language learning should look like. And part of that is actually interpersonal communication, like having an actual conversation with a real person. So it's really important for you to nail those assignment types. And in fact, in most cases, I actually prevent you from moving on in the course until you go back and complete them. A couple of them that are really important in particular is one, your unit projects. Every unit has a project. That's the end of your course, by the way, is your unit four project. There's no final exam. It's just the unit four project. But also units one and three, there are four units in class. Units one and three, or un and trois, have a phone call or the tête-à-tête assignment. You absolutely must do those. And I want to just say a quick word about this. My scheduling capabilities for those are going to diminish greatly going into January. So December, I still have some times open on the calendar, as you can see. But after that, I'm not going to be able to do much of those at all in January. So I want to encourage you to get those in. In some cases, if you don't schedule and don't do those, you will not pass the class because I won't grade your work if you don't complete those. I just want to be really upfront with that, how important that is to get those in and make sure you keep your appointment with me. If you're nervous or apprehensive about that at all, just let me know. We'll work through it. I'm a really nice guy to talk to on the phone, and I'm going to help you with the conversation as well. Okay. It's not a formal oral exam. It's an opportunity for you to speak French and to listen to my French as well. Okay. Other than that, I do also want to mention a few key dates. Like I said, make sure you know your end date. That part's really important. Blackboard is going to be down. That is like the course. You are not going to be able to access the course between December 25th and 28th. So it's going to be down for 4 days during the holiday break. So that's just something to be thinking about. Make sure you're planning around that. And then I am also going to be gone on vacation a good part of winter break. It's one of the only times that during the year, I get to really kind of take off for a week or so. I'm not leaving or going anywhere, but just to get a little time away from the computer. So December 22nd through about January 1st, January 2nd, I will be offline. So you can still work on the course. Those dates that Blackboard is online, but I won't be able to answer your questions or grade your work. And that's another reason that I don't give a lot of feedback going into January on assignments, just because there's a lot of work to catch up on and so much comes in at the end, okay? When in doubt, keep trucking along. Let me know if you have questions. Make sure you complete your unit projects and tete-a-tete phone call assignments. If you don't, you could be forfeiting your credit for the course because your work will not be graded without those required assignments. Okay? Merci. Bon courage. Au revoir. Let's make it a great December.